बस
So
ठीक है, ओके
firstly, a warm welcome to all the participants who are attending this webinar, and a very important webinar about financial planning after for the retirement purpose. But why at the age of 50? Because when you speak about the term retirement, we always feel there's good amount of time. Why do we start planning at such a early time? However, we at CMDC have been organizing regular programs on financial planning, and this was done initially just before the person gets superannuated, that is at the age of 60. And however, at that time we felt and we got a feedback from participants mentioning that this should have been done way beyond, way back, because अभी बता के क्या कैसे हम करेंगे, कैसे changes लाएंगे plans में. So we realized that this program has to be done well before the superannuation, before retirement, because the participant or the employee is aware about what is the initiatives or what are the decisions which a person needs to take to live a cheerful life after the superannuation. So hence, do all the hard work, do all the planning at the age of 50, so we can have a much relaxed, much cheerful life once we achieve the superannuation. So today we've introduced this webinar, and we have a very eminent faculty, Mr. Bahubali Shah. Mr. Shah, a very warm welcome to RCF for facilitating our employees on this very important topic, because right now this is of immense importance to all the participants in the current pandemic scenario, because what all participants must have planned is during the normal times, during the times when things were normal, the stock markets were fine, when we were getting the best of the returns. But with the stock falling down and all the market being going haywire because of the pandemic, corrective actions, corrective decisions needs to be reconsidered by the participants. And hence, this webinar is of much importance to the participants, because they're looking forward for your ideas, your suggestions about how they can make changes or how they can modify their plans. Mr. Shah, thank you very much for accepting our request, and I welcome you to RCF. Before I invite you for this webinar, to start the webinar, I would quickly brief through your credentials. So Mr. Bahubali Shah is from the BMS Financial, a firm in the profession of distribution of suitable financial products, and it was started way back in the year 1984 with the relevant knowledge, especially into the retirement solutions, ideas for planning for retirement, and on various suitable investments products for any of the financial goals in life. When I was speaking to Mr. Shah and I was trying to get about his bio data, he said he's a man of kind of he's seen it because of his experience and because of he's had a lot of his clients, and he has a experiential platform. So with this small input, I would again welcome Mr. Shah, and I would request you to facilitate our participants.
Thank you. Thank you, Rupali. Good afternoon, everyone. This is Bahubali Shah. As Rupali introduced about my career, started at 1984 in the venue of financial planning. And as we all aware that in financial planning, retirement planning is the most important planning, because ultimately we all work every day, we earn money, we complete our financial commitments, we have so many financial goals and all, and entirely everything is made only when we have a plan. Unless planning, we cannot do anything. Means planning is required for any important work in our life. Suppose tomorrow we have to travel somewhere, then also we make some planning. So planning is very important. Otherwise, it will be like a boarding a bus where there is no board. We are not aware where we are going. Nowadays, means in last 10 years, I'm meeting young professionals, young workers and all, where when I talk to them about financial planning, they come to me with bunch of their investments and I get puzzled, you know, so many plans, so many insurance policies, so many mutual funds, so many other things, and all are locked up in the investments with no results at all. Because exactly they are not aware what they are doing. And this happens mostly in the software type of companies, because there everything is online. Nowadays, the most you can say biggest culprit is excess information or the search engines, which are easily available. But we must understand that search engines are only to search the material. We never know whether that is right or wrong and how to analyze that. Suppose we are aware that we can analyze that properly and then use it, perfectly all right. But in our core area, when we are working or we are in the business or we are doing something at that time, we may not get proper time to analyze that. And unless we analyze anything, I don't think it will be appropriate to use that for our financial planning. Now, when I'm talking about financial planning and the retirement, particularly around the age of 50, it's very important to listen, because many out of you must have already planned so many things. Many out of you must be having so many financial products with you. But it's important at this juncture to verify all the instruments once again, their performance, take a nice review of the same, because now the return, by this time, most of you must have completed paying the EMIs for house, if you have taken the loans, spending on your expenditure for your children for higher education and all. Most of you must have already completed that, or some of you must be around reaching to that stage. Once you do that, then probably you are in the peak of your career. Probably you must be having good amount of salaries now and less liabilities. Means I hope so. Many people must have borrowed some loans, liabilities, and that also must be there. But I presume that everything is a conservative type of spender, and because now it is time to invest and make a very nice corpus for having a happy or cheerful career after retirement. Now, as Rupali also mentioned, or it is written in the board also, how to spend our retirement life cheerful. Means everyone wants cheerful life. Cheerful means cheerfulness comes only when we are capable enough of spending money when it is required. Now, if that is to be achieved, then we need to have freedom in finance. Now, freedom in finance is important, or it is possible only when there is enough money. Now, I don't say that money is the only important thing in life. We need to enjoy also, we need to spend money also, we need to do the things by doing which you get happiness. That is also important. But unless you understand that my future requirements can be this, and for that I need to provide certain amount of corpus for me, it is not going to be achievable in future. Because I also have a category of clients, when I start asking them what is your CTC, then suppose they will say me 3 lakhs. Now, out of 3 lakhs, how much is expense? No, my parents spend everything, I don't have any expense. And then I said, what is the bank balance now? No, there is no balance. So where is the money gone? No, I don't know. It's debit card we use, and whenever we want, we make some online purchase or something. So when I realized that, at that time, I explained them, unless we understand the value of every spending, we will not be in a position to save properly. Because unless we understand the value, we will not be able to save anything. We will keep on buying. I will tell you one small story of a friend of mine in Pune. He is working in telco, and his wife is a physiotherapist. Now both were earning approximately 1.5 lakhs per month, both together. So out of 1.5 lakhs, when I understood at that time, he was around his 37 of age or something. I went to him through some acquaintance. Then he became my friend. Then when we talked to him at that time, I understood that he has no cash flow available. Whatever money comes, it is already planned. And as soon as it gets credited to our accounts, it is spent also. So I was not in a position to understand 1.5 lakhs every month in Pune. Is it possible? So then after 2 months, I told him certain stories and all. And I said him, let's meet once again in next month. Till that time, just try and see how much you can share, spare out of your funds. Then next month when I went there, at that time he said, Bahubali ji, aap aaye hai to aap ek 5,000 ka mera SIP kar lo. Because I really don't have any surplus cash. Then I said, no, I will not do any SIP for you. I will give you one exercise. He said, okay, what is the exercise? I said, you bring up 100 pages rough book, notebook, and in that book, even if you spend 1 rupee, you note it down. Whole day, whatever you do, or your wife, both have to keep separate books, and they have to write and then spend. You spend it by card, you spend it by check, you spend it online, net banking, whatever. But first they have to write and then spend. Now, I told him second thing, that after 1 month, either I will come and check both the books or you exchange the books with each other and ask them to find out whether there is any expense that can be saved, means that need not be spent. Matlab, just I told him to make the list of such expenses which can be avoided. Now he said, kar lenge. So let's meet after 3 months and every month we will write that and we'll find out. Then without me telling them anything, after 3 months when I met him, at that time he said, we can save 20,000 rupees every month. Means the list was ready with each other. Means husband said, ye kharcha kyun kiya? Wife said, haan, ye kharcha kyun kiya? Ye avoid kar sakte, ye avoid kar sakte. And I had told them not to compromise on your happy spendings. Wherever it is required, you spend that. But just write that and let's meet after 3 months. So when I understood that 20,000 rupees at least they can take out, then I went there and I saw the expenses. In that expense, major expense what I saw was on his clothing. Clothing means shirts, pants, and all these things. Louis Philippe, Van Heusen, all those shirts and all. Then casually asked him, what is the timing of the office? He said, by 6 o'clock, we leave from here. And you come back, sir, late hota hai, wo to aane ko 8 baj jata hai. I said, what is a holiday? Then they said, it is Thursday. And I said, what about Mrs. who is a doctor? Said, no, she is also busy, right, from 8 o'clock till, because she gets calls for visits and all, and she is with apron most of the time. And we deal with the patients. And when we ask them, then why do you buy so many shirts and all? Then I come to know that shopkeeper used to send him some messages, naya lot aaya hai, aapko ekdam achha lagega. And then these people go on holiday to that shop and they say, sir, ye le lo, ye karal achha hai, ye aapko suit hoga, ye aisa hoga, waisa hoga. At least 10 shirts they will buy every month. And when I asked his wife, she said, sir, wo pehante bhi nahi hai, wo to sab hum gift hi dete hai sab logon ko. Every time. What I'm trying to say is, such are the expenses in our career also. I'm not spending, everybody must be doing that. But certain people, to maintain their dignity, to maintain their standard of living and all, many things we do just to show that we are also rich. Means your standard of living has to be very good. I don't compromise on that. But at the same time, there is no need of any unnecessary spending. And there has to be a good nest egg. Unless there is a good nest egg, the regular income, how it will be? It will not be possible. No? Okay. I will leave you with this story here only and we'll go back to retirement planning. Now, retirement planning, this word came with bigger importance when the style of living nowadays started of a nuclear families. Earlier, there were joint families. चार चार भाई लोग रहते थे, उनके बहुएं सबके, बाद में बच्चे सब साथ में, बिग हाउसेस, आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट नॉट ओनली मुंबई बट एवरीवेयर, एंड घर में कोई बड़ा आदमी रहता था, वो सब सैलरी सबका आता था तो उसके पास आता था, देन ही विल मैनेज एवरीथिंग एंड हिज वर्ड विल बी रिस्पेक्टफुली लिसन्ड बाय सेकंड जनरेशन एंड एवरीथिंग वाज ऑल राइट. सो कोई रिटायर भी हो गया, कुछ भी हो गया, तो डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ असाइनमेंट, ये आप बच्चों की तरफ ध्यान रखो, ये ऐसा करो वैसा करो, सब कुछ ठीक तरह से होता था. उस टाइम में भी देयर वर सेविंग्स, लाइक गोल्ड में इन्वेस्ट करते थे लोग, दे यूज टू इन्वेस्ट इन रियल इस्टेट, दे यूज टू बाय सम प्लॉट्स ऑफ लैंड्स, वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट, देन स्टार्टेड दीज पोस्टल सेविंग्स, देन स्टार्टेड सम म्यूचुअल फंड्स, देन स्टार्टेड मींस ग्रेजुअली एवरीथिंग स्टार्टेड चेंजिंग. Now in nuclear families, we have to start our career. Now while starting the career, we start getting responsibilities. Then we get married. Then we get children. Then we get to get them admitted into schools. Then their education starts, that expense starts. Our timings of working have changed to indefinite timing. Means fortunately you all are in PSU. I don't know, your timings are fixed or you're also spending a lot of time in working. But at the same time, earlier days, it was 10 to 6 or 10 to 5. Now that definition is gone. So we spend most of the time working or spending for our career. At that time, we hardly get some time to be at home or talk to children or see their progress or advise them anything, and that everything has to be done by the housewife or the servants. And most of the people's parents are either at native place or parents are not there, or we are in some overseas place for working. All these things are there. So for making all these adjustments, I always suggest my people, means my customers or my clients or my guests, that we should have a planning. Because we don't know tomorrow what is going to happen. Incidentally, this year only you have seen this pandemic. And in that pandemic, fortunately, you all are government or PSU. But many MSM enterprises, they could not give their full salaries, even half salaries. Even somewhere I have seen that people have not paid salaries for so many months. And many people have lost their jobs. They are trying to work hard, getting jobs elsewhere. So we even if we are happy, even if we have money, even if our salaries are on, if we realize that this also can happen, so we have to be alert. And when we are alert, at that time what we do is, when the expenses are 5 rupees, at least we try to get 8 rupees. So 3 rupees are surplus. So in that 3 rupees, we keep 1.5 rupees or 2 rupees for emergency and 1 rupee for saving. So that saving has a multiplying effect, that is compounding effect. So how much is a period in your hand, the multiplying effect will be bigger. Just to understand you, we suggest 3 types of risks in life. And in 3 types of risks, biggest risk is life. Suppose we start our career, we get married, then we get a child, and at that time suppose we think of making a financial planning, then we tell people that first you give priority for the insurance, means life cover, because that is the foundation of entire planning, because the term insurance is available at a very low cost. And means this is not today's subject, but I'm just putting one single thing in the financial planning phase, it will definitely help you to understand, if not for you, for your next generation or for your younger ones, younger brothers or whoever. So that term insurance works as a hedge against your financial loss in case something goes wrong. This pandemic, I have seen young people have died, young doctors have died. Many, many young people, now they have planned for all 20 years, 25 years from here. But since they were covered, they got the money. But if they have whoever not covered, they have gone. Means now their family is at stake. Now what to do about that? So financial planning has to be with a proper life cover, first thing. And life cover for whom? Who is a key person? If key person is properly on and adequately insured, then one thing is done. So that is the risk cover against unpredictable dying early. Now, what is the second risk in life? Second risk of life is when something happens and we are not aware, and suddenly doctor says that now he has to be admitted immediately. Now, you all are aware that suppose we get hospitalized, how much money we have to spend? Nobody can plan, means nobody can understand or nobody can imagine. Many times it can be 1 lakh also, many times it can be 10 lakhs also. And suppose you are well prepared with a small mediclaim policy that is covered. Spending is not much. Now, again, I say that for your people, this may not be applicable because RCF must be taking care of that. I am not aware of that, but that is important. In case RCF is taking care of that, my request is to once verify that policy nicely. Just talk to yourself whether that cover is adequate for you all or your family. And then that thing is taken care of. So what is that? That thing you have taken care of, that is unexpected spending, that is taken care of by what? This Mediclaim cover, health cover. So in case you feel that that cover is not adequate, then you can always buy it from market, additional cover. It is not very costly. Depending upon age, depending on your health, you can get that cover again. Now, third important planning is risk against living long. Now, you tell me about yourself. If you look at your family background, or if you look at your health, everybody wants to live long. Nobody will feel that, nahi, nahi, mera 60 saal ho gaya to bas ho gaya, 70 saal ho gaya to bas ho gaya, 80 saal ho gaya to bas ho gaya. Aap 85 year wale ko bhi poochho ki bahut ho gaya, aapko jaane ka kya bhi? Nobody will say that I want to go. If that is the case, then that is the real risk. From your age of retirement till you survive, how you are going to be taken care of? Many people will say that nahi nahi humne hamare bachchon ko bahut acha sikhaya hai and wo bade ho jayenge, unki salary achhi ho jayengi, they will take care of us. Hum log maza kar rahe, hum log spend kar rahe, hamare paas itna paisa bhi nahi hai, wagera wagera. Sir, aap itna soch ke dekho, ya to aap aisa samjho ki aapke paas, aapne planning karke aapke paas ek 50 lakh rupya ya 60 lakh rupya hai. You will get different type of respect from the family itself. Let it be your son's family, let it be your brother, sister, whomever you are staying with. But aapke paas agar paisa hai to aapko jo izzat milega ya to jis tarah se caring milega, wo aise bhi logon ko dekh lo ki jinke paas paisa nahi hai. I spend my time in taking some programs or events for senior citizen. And when I talk to them at that time, I really get depressed because there is no communication between this generation and earlier generation. Most of the cases, or the retiring people or retired people, they will have no say in their family. Just unke bachchon ko samalo. Just वो जब देंगे तब चाय पी लो, जब वो देंगे तब खाना खाओ, जैसा मिला है वैसा ही खाओ, उसमें नमक कम है, ये कम है, वो बोलने का ये नहीं है. एंड दिस एवरीथिंग कैन बी चेंज्ड इफ यू आर इंडिपेंडेंटली एंड एडेक्वेटली बिलोंग सम प्रॉपर्टी, बिकॉज एवरीबडी नोज दैट दिस इज इवन आई एम नॉट सेइंग एवरीबडी सन्स एंड डॉटर्स आर लाइक दैट. बट अगर समझो आप अभी वो प्लानिंग कर सकते हो तो इट इज बेटर, आप कर लो, बाद में वो पैसा उनको ही दे देगा तो आप कर लो. मैं तो बोलता हूं कि 50 साल तक आपने अगर आपके बच्चों के लिए बहुत कुछ अच्छा किया है तो अभी उनके बारे में ये मत सोचो कि मैं ये मेरा पैसा है इसमें से एक 40 लाख रुपए का एक घर लेगा और मेरा ये बच्चे को मैं दे देगा, बेटे को दे देगा। अरे भैया आपका घर है ना, वो आपके पास उसका ही होने वाला है ना। नहीं नहीं, एक पूना में भी रहेगा, नहीं तो मैं बाद में रेंटल देगा, नहीं तो मेरा एक हॉलिडे होम रहेगा। आप ट्राई कर लो कि उसमें ऑपरेशनल हजार्ड्स कितने हैं। Somebody will come and stay, rentals will not be proper, it will be taxable, stamp fee will have to pay, many changes, repairing, society. Mostly, I am the person to advise to invest only in cash instruments. Cash instruments means financial assets. Because financial assets, आप सोच लो, आपने कोई mutual fund में पैसा लगाया है, आपको वो पैसे का जरूरी है, 3 दिन में आपके अकाउंट में पैसा आ जाएगा, इससे इजी और क्या है बताओ। नाउ वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड कि मैं किसी प्रोडक्ट के बारे में आपको यहां नहीं बोल रहा, मैं खाली कंसेप्चुअल बातें करने के लिए यहां बैठा हूं। सो यहां पे इन बिटवीन सपोज किसी के माइंड में कुछ आ जाता है, क्वेश्चन पूछना है, वो भी पूछ सकते हैं, लेकिन आई प्रेफर कि आप चैट बॉक्स में लिख के आप जो भी फैसिलिटेटर है उनको दे दो, वो मेरे को पूछेंगे, या तो आप डायरेक्टली पूछ सकते हो जैसा आपको ठीक लगे। नाउ फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग में टाइमली फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग का कॉम्पैक्ट कितना होता है, मतलब इम्पैक्ट कितना होता है वो खाली आप देख लो। सपोज आप लोग एक महीने का 10,000 रुपए इन्वेस्ट कर रहे हैं एंड आपको एक 12% ग्रोथ होगा म्यूचुअल फंड में या इक्विटी मार्केट में, दैट इज पॉसिबल। एवरी ईयर दे विल नॉट गेट 12%, many times they will give you negative also, but on an average in long run 12% होने में कोई दिक्कत नहीं आनी चाहिए। तो समझो 12% के हिसाब से हम देख लेंगे और हमने अगर 10 years के लिए investment किया तो 10 years के लिए investment करने के बाद उसका value 23 lakhs बनता है, मतलब 10 years में आपका कितना जाएगा 12 lakh, 12 lakh का 23 बनेगा। ये मैं 10 साल का हिसाब बता रहा हूं, बट सपोज आपने 5 साल पहले चालू किया होता, मतलब 15 साल मिलेंगे आपको, तो 15 साल में आपको करीबन 50 लाख मिलेंगे। मतलब जो मैं 23 लाख बोल रहा हूं उसके बजाय 50 लाख हो जाएंगे। अभी 5 साल का आपका कितना 6 लाख रुपया ज्यादा गया, तो 6 लाख रुपए का हिसाब सीधा अमाउंट डबल हो गया। वही अमाउंट अगर आपने को 20 ईयर्स का पीरियड, मैं यहां देख रहा हूं कि बहुत सारे यंग लोग भी बैठे हैं, तो यहां पे अगर 20 इयर्स का किसी ने अगर प्लान किया, मतलब जो भी सूटेबल फंड है वो अगर लिया, तो उसका वैल्यू बन जाता है 12% के हिसाब से 1 crore। सो 20 इयर्स में कितने हो गए आपके, मतलब एक साल का अगर 1,20,000, तो 20 इयर्स का 24 लाख रुपया गया, तो 24 लाख का 1 crore बन जाता है। The main problem is many people try to see the performance on a daily basis. When they are in market link products, at that time, अगर daily basis पे performance देखोगे तो कभी कभी negative दिखाई देगा, तो अपना मन घबरा जाता है। And it is a common thing because nowhere in the world I have ever seen a person कि जिसका negative result आने के बाद उसको खुशी हुआ है, कोई किसी को नहीं होगा। बट वेन यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट द डिवैल्यूएशन और द नेगेटिव परफॉर्मेंस इज गोइंग टू एड मोर वैल्यू इन हिज परफॉर्मेंस, देन यू विल बी हैप्पी दैट चलो 2 साल नेगेटिव में आए तो मेरे को नंबर ऑफ यूनिट्स आई विल बी गेटिंग मोर बिकॉज माय इन्वेस्टमेंट इज गोइंग टू बी सेम अमाउंट। अभी यहाँ पे और एक छोटी स्टोरी में बताता हूं आपको, मतलब जस्ट टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज द कंपाउंडिंग वैल्यू। एक टीचर मेरे पास आया, उसको बच्चा होने के बाद, और मेरे को बोला कि आई एम अ टीचर, आई नो द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ स्टडीज एंड मेरा बच्चे के लिए मेरे को बहुत अच्छा एजुकेशन देना है एंड एजुकेशन और 18-20 साल के बाद बहुत ही महंगा हो जाएगा, सो सजेस्ट मी समथिंग। Then when I asked him what is your salary, He said salary was 6,500. I am talking about an incidence when it was 1995. Then I said, what is your wife doing? He said, she is also teacher. Her salary 3.5. So 6.5 and 3.5. So total salary 10,000. Now who are the members at home? He said, my mummy, daddy, we two and the child. So 5 people, 10,000 earning, staying in Mumbai. Now I thought I don't know how he will be able to sail, because kabhi emergency hua, kharcha aaya, to kaise karenge? He said, nahi sir, hum manage karenge, aap mere ko bata do. I said, how much easily you can give? He said, 3,000 rupiah main de sakta hun, mahine ka. I said, ek kaam karo, mere ko 3,000 kaise de sakte ho, wo batao. Then he made the calculation of 10,000 rupees salary. He showed me his house expense, vagaira, vagaira. So he was comfortable in running the house at that time in 4,000 rupees. So I said, fine, if you don't have any other expense, then you can start with 3,000. But I suggest you to start with 2,000. Then he said, sir, 2,000 mein kya hoga? I said, you start with 2,000. Then when your salary will increase, at that time you come to me and add 1,000. He said, okay, I will do that. Then incidentally, uska transfer ho gaya hoga, kuch bhi ho gaya hoga. But he told me that time that mere bank mein hamesha balance rahega. Mere bank se 2,000 rupiah every month jayega, matlab jayega. Aap uski chinta mat karo. And usne uska planning chalu kiya. Aap believe nahi karoge, 15 saal ho gaye. 15 saal tak usne mere ko contact nahi kiya. Then again he got transferred to Bombay from Panvel. Panvel gaya tha pehle. To Bombay mein aane ke baad ek din mila. When I asked him ki are kabhi office aa jao, zara aapka investment ka performance aapko dikhane ka hai. Because what I had done was a simple mutual fund SIP. And since he has told me that 18 saal he is not going to check what is happening to my investment, because he said, I trust you, so you will do the needful. So when he said he is not going to check or break the investment for 18 years, then I thought, why not take a little risk? Although that person was not from risk area, but his assurance that he will not disturb me in between, ki mera kitna ho gaya, ye kam kyun ho gaya, ye jyada kyun hua, ye sab usne mere ko jab bataya, तब मैंने मेरा खुद का कॉल लिया, बिकॉज ही सेड यू आर द पर्सन टू डिसाइड व्हाट एग्जैक्टली आई नीड टू डू. सो आई गेव हिम सिंपल एसआईपी ऑफ मिड कैप एंड स्मॉल कैप. आई एम श्योर यू ऑल अंडरस्टैंड मिड कैप स्मॉल कैप. सो इन दैट उसने जो चालू किया था 15 साल के बाद हिज वैल्यूएशन वॉज मीन्स ही हैड इन्वेस्टेड समथिंग 3 lakhs एंड ऑड बाय दैट टाइम. And the valuation after 15 was around 50 lakhs. Now I myself was surprised, because we are also not regularly checking on each of the customer. I am aware that this person is for long term and his investment is meager 2,000. So there is no point in checking again and again, kitna ho gaya, kya ho gaya, wagera wagera. Then 15 saal ke baad jab main figure dekha, at that time I was a bit surprised. So I said, mera software mein to kuch gadbad nahi hai na. So I called up that AMC and I told them to send me the statement. Then they sent me the statement. The amount was the same. Then I called up this guy and I told him that you have to see the performance, because 18 years is just 3 years away. And suppose market comes down, then this category can come down. So he said, ki, sir, kuch bhi ho, main 18 saal tak aapko nahi milunga, uske bare mein. Aur kuch kaam hai to batao. I said, no, if you trust me, if you understand me, you are going to visit my office and I am going to explain you where we are. And that time you can take your call. He said, perfectly, all right. So he came here and I told him, ki, sir, aapne ye invest kiya hua hai and this is the valuation. He literally started counting the figures. One, ekam, dham, shatam, sasra. Means Marathi mein, he started counting. He said, sir, itna bada figure mein jindagi mein dekha nahi hai. I said, but this value is there today. Then I suggest you as a financial consultant to protect your interest, to switch it to safer fund. Because this 50 lakhs is beyond your imagination. So shift it to safer fund. So the value will not come down. But suppose value comes down at that time, he said, haan, kitna hoga? Value kam hoga to kitna hoga? I said, 6-7 lakh rupay kam ho sakte. Because after reaching to certain level, the valuation cannot drastically come down. It will come down to specific levels. And with that level, I told him that 6-7 lakh rupay isme kam ho sakte. Then he said, ki, sir, upar jane ka bhi chance hai kya? I said, yes, if market goes up, it will go up. But you have to take a conscious call. Then he said, ki, sir, I'm ready to take risk. I will pay you another 3 years and let my money go down or whatever. But I will continue with my scheme. I have a record of that statement. I can share with you without his name and all. He got 78 lakhs after 18 years. He and his wife visited my office. That time I told him that itna valuation ho gaya hai. At that time, they come with preparation in my office. They brought that small thali or something in that kumkum or haldi or sab kuch. Aake phoolon ka ek guldashta. वो सब दे के मेरे पैर पड़ के वो सब लगा के मेरे को बोला कि खाली मेरा बच्चे का प्लानिंग आपने नहीं किया सर, हमारा रिटायरमेंट का प्लानिंग भी आपने कर दिया. हाउ मच वॉज द पीरियड? इट वॉज 18 ईयर्स. हाउ मच वॉज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन? 2,000 rupees. ही डिडंट इवन इंक्रीज दैट आफ्टरवर्ड्स. ओनली 2,000 ही वॉज पेइंग. एंड व्हाई आई टोल्ड यू दिस स्टोरी, the compounding effect can be seen only in long term. But nowadays, after 3-4 years, hum logon ko sab kuch available hai. Mobile mein sab dikhta hai. Apne ko report milta hai. Toh hum log usse, we get impacted with that. And we immediately say, sir, apna fund negative dikha raha hai. Aap benchmark ke saath tally kar sakte ho. Benchmark matlab, jo stock market hai, wo agar 10% down hua hai, और आपका फंड अगर 15% डाउन हुआ है, then you can definitely worry for कि ये कुछ तो गलत है. मार्केट इतना नीचे गया तो मेरा फंड इतना नीचे कैसे गया? 10% से 10% हुआ तो ठीक है, 10% से 6% गया नीचे तो यू कैन से दैट हाँ, माय फंड मैनेजर हैज डन गुड जॉब. व्हेन मार्केट हैज कम डाउन 10%, ही हैज गॉन डाउन ओनली 6%. सो व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से, वो भी उतना एग्जैक्टली दिखने का जरूरी नहीं है. But I'm just saying, in between, अगर आपको करना है तो. Many people come to me and tell me that, sir, ये अपना 4 SIP जो चालू किया है, उसका हम लोग जरा मॉनिटर करना चाहते हैं, so आप हमको हमारे मोबाइल में उसका लिंक दे दो. हम लोग दे देते हैं, but we tell people, these are market link product, you are very young, long term में आपको बहुत पैसा कमाना है, तो कुछ भी मत करो. अगर समझो कोई स्कीम गलत हो गया, then we will come forward and tell you, that scheme is wrong. The features have been changed. This change has happened in the AMC and we will change the scheme. But for that, you need to have a faith. You need to understand that, yes, Mr. So-and-so is with us. He will advise me and he will always try to protect my interest. Suppose you will think that, अरे यार उसको कितना पैसा मिलता है मालूम नहीं, वो उसको जो फायदा मिलता है वही वो देगा वगैरह वगैरह. हाँ, there are many culprits like that. I don't say that ऐसा कोई नहीं होता है, बट आपको थोड़ा सा डीलिंग करने के बाद आपको उसका जजमेंट आ जाता है. बिकॉज आपने इन्वेस्टमेंट किया तो आप आपके फ्रेंड को बोलते हो, आपका फ्रेंड बोलता है कि यह बराबर नहीं है, आप बोलोगे कैसे आपको मालूम? देन ही विल से दैट देखो मेरा एजेंट ने मेरे को ये दिया है. उसमें डिस्कशन हो जाएगा. कभी कभी आपने पिताजी बोलेंगे, कभी आपने बच्चे बोलेंगे. ये मतलब आजकल कम्युनिटी इज ऑलवेज इन कम्युनिकेशन. And the communication is a good way of talking to each other and expressing apne jo bhi real thoughts hai, wo ek dusre ko express karenge wagera wagera. So I just told you the compounding effect. I just told you the volatility impact ka fayda kaise hota hai. Ye do cheeze. Now let's come back to our main topic, retirement planning. नाउ रिटायरमेंट प्लानिंग में जो रूटीन में आप पढ़ते हो, रूटीन में जो आप सुनते हो, वही सब सब बताने का मेरे को कोई इंटरेस्ट नहीं है अनलेस यू विल आस्क मी समथिंग. अभी फिलहाल मैं इतने बोलता हूं कि किसने ज्यादा ये किया नहीं है, इन्वेस्टमेंट्स नहीं किया है, लेकिन अभी फंड्स है, दे कैन इन्वेस्ट. देन दिस इज अ टाइम टू कैच अप म्यूचुअल फंड्स बिकॉज यू हैव 10 इयर्स इन हैंड. India story is becoming positive. There are so many threats to Indian economy, but at the same time, whenever leadership is good, means I am not praising anyone, huh? Please don't misunderstand. When the leadership is good, or when the reforms are good, when everything is happening nicely, then there is a chance that market can go up. And if market can go up, your mutual funds also will go up. Means valuation will always be good. Otherwise, if you will think, if you will not use mutual funds, where you will go? What is the way out? Because postal investments are all taxable. Second thing, postal investments, now the rate is attached to RBI rates. Every time RBI will change the rate, this also will change the rate. Now, these things are happening. Means nobody is committing any rates in long run. Wherever you will keep the company deposits and all, we are not sure whether that company will repay or no. Now what is left? Some insurance companies, pension plans. Yes, some of them are good. You are at least informed that this amount you are going to get. And if it is based on today's interest rate, then it is always good. So my point of telling you is, you try to understand first, what do you have today as a corpus or investments spread over different types of assets, then make analysis of that with a friend of you or advisor like me or yourself. You are capable of तो वो देख लो कि आपके हाथ में आगे के 10 साल है और आपका जॉब है, जॉब में आपका कितना कितना मिलने वाला है एंड उसके अगेंस्ट आपके लाइबिलिटीज कितने हैं. इसका पिक्चर अगर क्लियर हो जाएगा देन वी कैन हैव सम कमिटमेंट आइदर एडिशनल और डिफरेंट. सपोज टुडे यू हैव सम कमिटमेंट फॉर सम प्लान व्हिच इज नॉट प्रोडक्टिव एट ऑल, देन frank advisor like me will immediately tell that you shut down this, it doesn't have any credentials, this plan is like this, this point blank we can tell you. And then when you understand that this is a product which is suitable to cater your needs in future, then that is the way we have to align our investment as on today and then start the journey from here. Rupali, you want to say something? Yeah, okay. So the further thing what I want to advise is we also need to set realistic goals. Because now I met one person, he told me that mere ko invest matlab mera retirement ke baad 40 lakh rupaye jama ho jayega, usme main char betiyan hai meri, उसको मैं 5-5 लाख रुपए दे दूंगा और 20 लाख में मेरा फाइनेंशियल प्लानिंग कर दो. नाउ विथ हिम हिज वाइफ इज देयर, डॉटर्स आर मैरिड, दे आर हैप्पीली इन देयर फैमिली, दे डोंट नीड पापाज 5 लाख रुपीज ईच बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव सन. सो आई कन्विंस दैट गाय दैट 5 लाख मत दो, उनको ज्यादा पैसा दो. But let that money go to them when you both are not there. As in, because it is going to be compromised on your regular income. So all these things you need to consider, because कभी कभी हम sensitive हो जाते हैं, अपने को लगता है कि नहीं इसको इतना help करना है, उसने मेरे लिए उतना किया इतना किया, जरूर help करो. But unless you are strong enough, you will not be in a position to help him in long run. And kiske bare mein help karna aapko acha lagta hai, usko aap strong hoke help karoge, So that help will be much stronger than today's small help. So this is what. Then most important, one more thing I would like to tell you. मैंने हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस के बारे में बताया, बट आज के हिसाब में आपके सर पे अगर कुछ डेट है क्या देख लो, डेट मतलब लाइबिलिटी, आप सोच के ये भी देखो मैंने किसी फ्रेंड को गारंटी दिया है क्या, बिकॉज दैट गारंटी ऑल्सो इज लाइक अ डेट ओनली. सपोज ही विल नॉट पे, द लेंडर विल कम टू यू, एंड दैट इज वेरी रिस्की नाउअडेज. सो try to analyze, try to find out whether you have taken any loan, what is the rate of interest, when that loan will be paid off, what should be my priority, whether I should pay off the loan or I should invest in mutual funds or in any other instrument that you like, that you have to think of. Then you have to also find out whether there is any guarantee I have given, that also you need to check. And if guarantee is given, try to contact that friend and or try to talk to that guy. Otherwise, if you're not in good terms with that guy, go to that bank straight away or the institution where you are given the guarantee and tell them that this was the guarantee I had given and what is the today's position. Then they will say that no, wo to pay ho gaya. Then you write it off. Matlab wo pay ho gaya, khatam ho gaya. Then you tell them that आप मेरे को एक कंफर्मेशन दे दो कि आपका गारंटी का अभी क्लेम निकल गया, बिकॉज टुमारो ही विल टेक वन मोर लोन एंड सेम गारंटी विल कंटिन्यू. इट डजंट हैव एनी सेंस. ऐसा होता नहीं है, बट आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू दैट आजकल कुछ भी हो सकता है. बैंक वाला उसका अगर फ्रेंड होगा तो वही कुछ डेट भी चेंज करके कुछ भी करके वही गारंटी लगाएगा उधर. देन ऐसा होता नहीं है, लेकिन फिर वो लीगल इश्यू बन जाएगा. फिर अपने पास जो स्टेमिना 30 साल के थे, जो स्टेमिना 40 साल के थे, वो स्टेमिना आज नहीं होता है. सो मैं आई एम नॉट डिस्करेजिंग, बट आई एम टेलिंग यू द फैक्ट्स. सो यू हैव टू एंश्योर दैट यू आर नॉट कैरिंग ओवर एनी लोन्स, यू आर नॉट अंडर एनी ऑब्लिगेशन ऑफ एनी लाइबिलिटी वगैरह. देन थर्ड थिंग इज, आपको अगर लगे कि माय इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर गुड, लेकिन पता नहीं जब तक मैं इन्वेस्टमेंट का प्लानिंग, फाइनल प्लानिंग करूं, जब इन्वेस्टमेंट तब इंटरेस्ट का रेट क्या होगा. अभी इंटरेस्ट के रेट्स इतने फास्ट नीचे जा रहे हैं कि वन ऑफ माय फ्रेंड हु इज इन आरबीआई, वी वर जस्ट कैजुअली टॉकिंग एट द टाइम ही सेड कि रिसेंटली वी हैड अ मीटिंग एंड देयर द डिस्कशन वॉज टेलिंग मेकिंग मी रियलाइज दैट नेक्स्ट ईयर बैंक्स विल कम डाउन टू 3.75%. The highest rate on bank deposits can come down to 3.75. Of course, this was his own judgment, but my friend is a big officer. We say he will not take unnecessary anything. And if I try to take his opinion and try to judge whether that can be true, then everything, every action by government tells me to believe that, because postal rates are coming down, PPF rates are coming down, the RBI yield is coming down, then probably if India is in good books of the world, then probably income generation will be very high. There will be biggest FDIs after this China issue and all. So itna sara paisa agar India mein aa jayega, then banks may not require so many funds. So what I'm trying to say is, don't depend on what rate I will be getting after 10 years. Try something like booking that rate today. If there is any instrument that can tell you that, yes, you will get whole life this rate of interest, then try and catch that instrument. So to understand that instrument, then we can always communicate with each other. Miss, let me tell you in between, I have a special relation with RCF. Although I am not day to day coming to your office or dealing with anyone except Mr. Sharad Sonone, in 2007 I had traveled to Alibag for your all seniors retirement planning presentation. I think it was 2007 or 2006. So this is my second time I am with you, and I am very happy that you all remembered me and called me again. So this is what I just want to tell you. Now I will tell you one more story. One person came to me who was working in Premier Automobile. Now that person was a regular investor with me, but with a very small amount. Those days he will come and deposit 1000 rupees one time. He will invest 500 rupees one time. So because he was a labor community, means he was at a very low salary person, but I used to always like that because he's regularly investing. Right from his career, he used to invest. Now, when that person got retired, at that time, he got 16 lakhs. And he came to me. Sir, mere paas 16 lakh rupiya mila hai mere ko. Abhi iska retirement planning. I asked him, what is your regular income now? By all other sources, any pension, anything. He said, sir, kuch bhi nahi hai. I said, any expense you have predicted out of these 16 lakhs rupees? He said, haan sir, 6 lakh rupay ka kharcha hai. I said, what is that? He said, ek loan hai, wo repay karna hai. Abhi mere ko interest nahi dene ka hai, to wo pay karne ka hai, kyunki mera income band ho gaya. So left out is only 10 lakhs. To main usko kya planning de du? It is a matter of almost 2012 or something. So 2012, with 10 lakhs rupees, to make a provision for his family was very difficult. You all can understand that. So I said, give me 2 days. So 2 days I was thinking on that. What should I do? Then I suddenly one day I remembered that last time when I went to his house, his wife had made a chuda. Aap chuda samajhte hai na sab log? Marathi bolte hai na. Chuda, mane churmure ka banana tha na. Chuda banaya tha. So when his wife gave me the chuda, it was very tasty, very tasty. It was something different. And I had praised at that time only, chuda bahut hi achha banaya karke. And that I remembered now, means when I was thinking at home something about that family, ki main unko planning kya de du. And next day I went to office and I called him, ki aapko time hai to aap aa jao karke. Then he said, sir, aaj nahi, main kal aau to chalega kya, kyunki main outstation hu, wo loan repay karne ke liye aaya tha. I said, nahi, aaram se aa jao, jab aaoge tab milo mere ko. Then he came and वो आने के बाद वो भूल गया होगा, मैंने ही फोन किया, क्या वो भाई आए क्या नहीं है? हाँ सर आया हूँ, तो आज मिलू क्या? मैं आज ही आया हूँ. तो मेरे को लगा he is tired. So then I said, don't worry, I'll come to your place. So I went to his place. It was in Washi only. तो मैं वाशी में जाने के बाद मैंने पूछा कि आपका प्लान क्या है, क्योंकि आप बॉम्बे में इतने पैसे में तो आप कर नहीं पाओगे. Then he said, sir, मेरा इधर मेरा खुद का घर है वाशी में, तो मेरा रहने का तो प्रबंध है, गांव में कुछ है नहीं, तो आप कुछ भी सजेस्ट करो, मैं करने को तैयार हूं. मेरा माइंड में आया, बुरा नहीं मानना. तो उसने बोला, क्या आया माइंड में? मैंने बोला, अभी पैसे आपके पास कितने हैं? 10 लाख. वो बोला हाँ. मैं बोला, 2 लाख FD कर दो, इमरजेंसी के लिए यूज करो, कभी मेडिकल आएगा, कुछ आएगा, कुछ आएगा, बाकी रहेगा 8 लाख. 8 लाख में 4 बाइसिकल ले लो. तो बोला, सर क्या बोल रहे? मैं बोला, तुम मेरा प्लानिंग सुन लो, बाद में 4 अच्छे बच्चे कलेक्ट करो कि जो साइकिल चला सकते हैं, एंड दोज आर पुअर एंड दे वांट टू मेक सम मनी. ही सेड हाँ ओके. आई सेड देन यू बाय सम यूटेंसिल्स वगैरह वगैरह सब मैं बताया, एंड मैं बोला कि नाउ यू बोथ हैव टू वर्क, वाइफ एज वेल एज यू, एंड you start making that chuda and put it on a bigger box and put it on cycle and let the boy go to college or somewhere where in the beach mein ka chutti hota hai na wo time mein, ya to wahan pe thoda sa fresh chuda kuch din ke liye aap free de do, ek din ya do din ke liye. After 2 days you start charging and reasonable charge karo. सर आप बिलीव नहीं करोगे, वहां पे उसने विद इन नेक्स्ट 2 इयर्स ही बॉट 1 more flat, क्योंकि ही ओनली डिड इन हिज लाइफ वाज बाइंग अ प्रॉपर्टी. तो अभी उसका मतलब नाउ ही इज नॉट इन मुंबई बिकॉज हिज फैमिली मेंबर्स और समबडी सेड कि आप गांव में आके वही कर सकते हो वगैरह वगैरह. नाउ ही हैज गॉन समवेयर नियर पुणे बट देयर आल्सो बिग कॉलेजेस आर देयर एवरीथिंग इज देयर एंड दे ही सेज दैट सर ये मैं नहीं छोड़ूंगा एंड हिज वाइफ इज वेरी हैप्पी समबडी लाइक माय चूड़ा एंड समबडी प्रेज दैट एंड अल्टीमेटली दैट वॉज मेड एज हिज इनकम सोर्स. Now, these are just practical stories and I'm just sharing with you. It doesn't mean that I'm telling someone to do that. But anything can happen if you have a wish and you have a confidence. So here I would like to wait for some time. And if you have some questions, you can please ask me. Rupali is there.
There are some questions in the chat. So, Rupali, you want to take them or should I go ahead?
You can go ahead, Larissa.
Okay.
It was basically about the EMIs which are adjusted till the retiring month. Okay. Mr. Satish Shetty, can you just ask your question again? Because I think this is, we're not able to relate it to what is that exactly that you want.
Actually, sir was saying that the EMI should be finished off first. The home loans and all should be finished off first. But actually, nowadays what they do is the banks, they adjust the EMI in such a way that the EMI is continued till your retirement date, the last month of the retirement. But I think you said something that the EMI should get over, the home loan should get over way before your retirement.
Sir said, I could not hear you properly, but what I can understand, I will tell you. Then you tell me whether I have understood rightly. You have some EMIs going on a regular basis.
Home loan.
Home loan, okay.
Yeah.
You got that moratorium benefit. You're talking about that?
No, no, not about the moratorium. The home loans are adjusted in such a way, the banks adjust the home loans in such a way that it continues up till your retirement month. But I think you're of the opinion that it should get over way before your retirement.
That is a ideal situation because nobody will like that when you have no earnings. Then why should you carry the liability?
No, no.
That's a way of doing that.
I said till the retirement month, last month of your retirement. Till then the EMIs are adjusted. The home loans are adjusted in such a way that the retiring month also you have to pay your this thing. Or say one year before that.
Okay, how old you are?
I am 52 now, 53.
Okay. And how much can be the portion of that loan as on today?
Around 5 to 6 lakhs, I suppose.
Okay, and rate must not be more than 9.5?
No, it's 8.5, I think.
8.5. Okay, let that be continued. Till your maturity, whatever retirement date or whatever,
okay.
It is a reasonably low rate of interest. And anyway, you are completing it at the last day on the retirement.
I think 1 year before that. Okay.
Yeah. Huh. So with that, whatever is left out from there, you can create some assets because employers will definitely give you some incremental salaries. Some additional things to create your corpus again. So on that basis, you can take a call on individual basis in case you need anything without any obligation from either your side or my side. I can always advise you if you write a mail to me and I will not tell you that you come and invest with me or whatever. On purely friendship basis, I will advise you perfectly.
Okay, thank you, sir. Good enough. Okay.
Yeah. Your next question was about PPF. Can you elaborate on that?
Okay, I'll tell you. Now, most of you people must be having the PPF. And since all these guys are 50, around 50 or 52 or 53 or so. So now the period left is only 7 years. PPF as such, I never recommend. The reason is PPF is the interest rates, it is coming down. From 12%, now it is some 7.4 or something.
Yeah,
so I don't encourage that, But at the same time, when your retirement is only 5-6 years ahead, then that you have to look at that product as a in a positive manner, and it is growing tax-free growth. So that is a very good thing, because anything taxable now will be added to your income. So I will advise you not to discontinue your PPF, but don't do it additionally, because try to use mutual funds in a very good faith. I'm telling you, mutual fund is the area where you can much more money than PPF. PPF, just for the sake of continuation purpose, you can invest 500, 1000, 2000. That is perfectly all right. Of course, this is my personal view. Many chartered accountants, many investment advisors will always tell that, nahi, wo 1.5 lakh rupees usme dal do. But I'm thinking in different perspective. If I'm thinking that same growth, if you're better growth, if you get in different avenue where there is no lock-in, so why not? And when economy is growing, then your investments will definitely grow. So I'm using, or I'm telling, suggesting that instead of PPF, you try and use mutual funds.
So what are the investment you suggest for the persons those are retiring in a short period now? Because the interest rate is going down.
Short means 5 years or so?
Yeah, for 5 years, next 5 years. Because rate of interest is going down and mutual fund, okay. But the certainty of the returns is not there. But what are the fixed deposit schemes?
I will tell you, if you are a really conservative person, then if you don't want to enter into market at all, then fixed income securities are available in the market. If you want to buy some debentures from the market, secondary market, those are good things, debentures. And those are available in secondary market, means you have to go in the stock market, and through trader, you can always buy that. It will go in your demat account. It will give you little more than the prevailing rates of interest. Second avenue, but of course that is taxable. Second avenue, or my favorite avenue, is mutual fund only. And for people like you or who are not willing to take maximum risk, but ready to play with small risk, then those can go with hybrid funds in a conservative manner. Conservative means the proportion is managed. So when it is managed by fund manager, that wherever he will feel that there is a risk now, he will reduce the percentage of equity. So such funds are available in the market, and I my gut feeling is same fund will give you at least 10% returns over 5 years. CAGR means compounding rate.
Compounding interest. Fine.
So my, according to me, mutual fund will beat anything. Only thing, you'll have to choose the funds very carefully.
Sir, in our case, we have got a LIC pension fund scheme. Okay. And at the retirement time, there is an option. You can take out 1/3. In case of some other schemes are also there, pension scheme, where you can take out some 1/3 of your deposits at the time of retirement. Or you can take a fixed pension. Now, which option will be better at this stage? Whether we should keep the funds with them 1/3, or we should take out the funds and invest somewhere else?
There are two options. One is, some people have some lump sum payment to be made for certain reason. In that case, he can take that 1/3, because that is tax free. Okay. But if that need is not there, then I will prefer to continue with full pension. The reason is, LIC is managing your superannuation. LIC has big amount of corpus in that fund, and they have a rule: whatever they earn, it has to be distributed between all the policyholders. If that is the case, then their assumed age is, say, 90 years or 100 years for everyone. Accordingly, they have declared the rate and they give the pension. So long time many people must have died at 65, many people must have died at 85, many people died at 75. So their next amount, what was supposed to be paid to them, is LIC's profit. So it is added back to your corpus. Corpus means that superannuation ka jo fund hoga, usme wo add ho gaya. And because of that, they will not reduce the rate and they will give you better rate. Particularly, I'm talking about only superannuation. I'm not talking about the pension plan of LIC. I'm talking about only superannuation. So what you can do is, you will definitely get in advance. If you take a full pension, how much you get, then you will also get a working. If you take one third, then how much you get. And on that basis, with a proper analysis, we can take our decision.
You suggest the same thing for NPS also? National Pension Scheme?
No, NPS IPT is supposed to have both options. It will give you fantastic returns. It will grow nicely. And according to my information, because NPS is not our product, it is directly given to everyone. But I understand, for NPS is not going to give you the pension. What I was trying to tell you is, on maturity, I think Mr. Deepak is there, na?
Yes, I am there. Yes, sir, I am there.
So I was telling you, when NPS will be matured, at that time they will give you the same similar type of option. 40% you can take tax free, then 60% can be given to the any insurance company of your choice. So at that time we can take a right decision. But other company, what rate pension is to be given, it is decided on that date. Suppose that rate is very small, then we can always take 40% in mutual funds or find some other good area of investment.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
Awesome. Yes, sir. Mr. Nitin.
The next question is on mutual funds. Should we go for small caps, large caps, or mid caps out of the surplus to be invested? What should be the breakup of investment?
There is a, I will just say, different varieties of assets, large cap, mid cap,
small cap.
Okay, so hello.
Yes.
So when we want to choose, say, small cap. Now there is small cap ka, we need to understand what is small cap. First, 100 companies according to its market capitalization is large cap. Next 150 is mid cap, and beyond that it is small cap. And beyond that, suppose in mutual fund, beyond that everything is small cap, but mutual funds play with only next 200 to 300 companies only, because some small caps today they are there, tomorrow they will not be there. So select mutual fund, companies are selected by small cap fund managers. In small cap, there is always a chance of multiplying your investments, but there is the highest risk, because who has invested in small cap before 4 years, before 5 years? Today also, except one or two mutual funds, they are minus 20%. So that type of risk is there. But it is also possible that suppose today you invest in small cap, next year it will be double. Because if I give practical example, 1,000 rupees share, suppose a good news comes, it will grow by say 400 rupees. So 400 rupees is what percentage? It is 40% percentage. But in small cap, it grows by 400%. Because agar samjho 25 rupees ka stock hai, to 50 rupees bhi jayega. Uska good news agar aaya, and wo jaldi niche bhi nahi aayega. आज 50 हुआ, कल 60 हुआ, कल 70 हुआ, कल 90 हुआ, ऐसा बढ़ते जाएगा. सो देर हैज टू बी बैलेंस्ड अलोकेशन बेस्ड ऑन आवर एज प्रोफाइल एंड द रिस्क एपेटाइट. म्यूचुअल फंड इज अ वेरी इजी सब्जेक्ट बट इट इज डिफिकल्ट इफ यू लाइक टू प्लान नाइसली. वंस इट इज अंडरस्टूड then you, nobody of this group will ever leave mutual fund investment. Because I have seen people, they are using mutual funds as their one, like their business. Their purpose is consistent. They have small cap, they have mid cap, they have small, large cap, they have focused mutual fund. There are a variety of mutual funds. So anyone wanted whatever information, we can always come back. So in case specific query, again, you have in some mind, because I'm seeing you are already showing me that you still ask me something.
No, no, it's clear. This question was asked by participant Shetty M. So if in case he has any further questions on this.
Yeah, yeah.
Mr. Shah, thank you very much. It was very helpful. Okay, my follow-up question was, you know, out of the pool of money, the surplus money that we have, what should be the ideal kind of a breakup for investment?
Yeah, it depends again with your horizon. What horizon you are looking for. Say it is 2 years to 3 years, it has to be conservative hybrid fund. If it is about 5 years, it can be a large cap or aggressive hybrid or small percentage in large cap. If it is 7 years plus, it can be multi-cap focus funds or some portion mid-cap. So it depends upon what type of risk appetite you have and what type of your financial goal is. Because the goal is ultimately any investment which helps you to meet your goal, that is a good investment.
Thank you very much. Got it.
Yeah.
So the next question is about good investment itself. Whether they should invest in mutual funds, equity or property, the retirement is after 19 years.
Okay. So there are two types of investments. One is a real estate, one is a agricultural field. Then in real estate, there are two again. Residential property, commercial property, or you can say three types plots. So first thing, where he wants to buy the property. Suppose he wants to buy a property to make an alternate avenue of income. So it has to be in city only, Pune, Mumbai, or any city. He can get the rentals. Now let's come to personal view of real estate. Now if you will check the real estate prices. Almost 2 years, the prices have not moved. In fact, it has come down. If anybody will check up their mobile phone, they will get at least 4 to 5 advertisement or messages. 1 BHK available at this price, 2 BHK available at this price. Prices negotiable, occupancy ready, full payment to be made only after you occupy the house. It definitely means that buyer's market. When it is buyer's market, then to expect returns out of that investment may not be practical. Because even my office is in Chembur, where I used to get about 25 to 30,000 rupees rental for 1 BHK flat, or 35 to 50,000 for 2 BHK flat. Hey, calls. 25,000 देने को अगर तैयार है तो मैं देने को तैयार हूँ. 2 साल के लिए ले लो. Of course, I don't know the situation, how the house is, वगैरह वगैरह. And I don't want. But some of the clients, when they discuss, I come to know about that. Now, in the recent story, one of my NI clients wanted to buy 3 BHK in Chembur. He finalized one house at quarter to 3 crores, means 2.75 crores, and just at the time of finalization, he called me. It's a matter of 6 months before he called me, and he said, I like that flat like anything. It is 3 BHK, and that is the only flat left, and there are almost 6-7 customers behind me, but he said ki you are an NRI customer, I want to give preference to you, so you pay me next day, then I'm ready to give you this flat. I said all these things. He said yes. Then I said don't buy that property. He said sir aap aisa kyun bolte ho, mere wife ko bhi pasand hai. Matlab aapko pasand hai, aapke paas itna paisa bhi hai, but suppose aapko ek 5-6 mahine ke baad wahi property 2 crore mein milta hai, aisa agar malum padega to then you should be ready to face that situation. You should not think that mera 75 lakhs ka nuksan ho gaya, because I am aware that you are not going to stay there immediately because you have a nice house elsewhere. You are buying it for some 10 saal ke baad mere ko lagega to main use karunga wagera aisa cheez ke liye. You are not going to give it on rental also. Then he said sir wo mera piche 5 log pada hai aisa bolta hai. I said aap try kar lo, mere upar bharosa hai to aap usko bolo ki let me check my budget and come back to you. Itna hi sentence bolo. Then we said that sir mera zara main dekh ke batata hu aapko, and he went home immediately. He called up, abhi pahuncha bhi nahi ghar pe, usko phone aaya ki are sir aap kitne baje tak pahunchoge, kyunki mere ko customer log takleef de rahe hai, nahi to mere ko kisi ko aur ko dena padega. He said sir 1 o'clock tak main bataunga aapko, and it was 12:30. Then he requested me to come over to his house. So I went there. I explained him, I said I am going to be here and I am telling you 1 o'clock you have given the time, so he is not supposed to call before that, but 1:01 mein uska call aayega, aur uska call aayega to aap dekh lena, because you were supposed to call him up, so you didn't call, so then he will be worried and he will call. At that time you tell ki my budget is not so much, it is thoda sa stretched ho raha hai, and main thoda dekh raha hu मेरे को परवर्ता है क्या नहीं परवर्ता है. डोंट टेल दैट यू रिड्यूस द प्राइस, यू डू दिस डू दैट, कुछ मत बोलो. एंड ही सेड दैट, देन ही फर्स्ट अब्यूज्ड हिम. ही सेड कि क्या यार मजाक लगा रखा है क्या, मेरे पास इतने कस्टमर थे, मैं आपके ऊपर वेट कर रहा था, चलो ठीक है फिर आपको कोई चांस नहीं मिलेगा, मैं किसी को भेज देगा. एंड ही वॉज वरीड, नाउ हिज वाइफ इज लुकिंग एंग्रीली विद मी, बिकॉज उसका माइंड में वो घर बहुत आया था. मैंने बोला कि भाभी चिंता मत करो, that fellow will call you again. Then thoda der gaya, 2 o'clock again he calls up. He said ki maine sabko bula hua hai ki ek din main wait karunga, baad mein bataunga, to aap aisa karo sir, aap kaisa budget ka wagera sab dekh ke mere ko sham tak phone karo. I said sir abhi phone mat karo, abhi phone aayega to bolna ki mera 2 crore tak kaisa bhi khinch ke hota hai, uske upar mera budget hi nahi hai. Aap aisa nahi bolna ki aapka value zyada hai, kam karo, मेरा बजट ही इतना है. और आप बिलीव नहीं करोगे, वो ट्रांजैक्शन हो गया विद इन नेक्स्ट 3 डेज हो गया. दैट ट्रांजैक्शन टुक प्लेस एट 2 crores and 15 lakhs. नाउ 2 crores and 15 lakh, दैट आल्सो बिकॉज़ हिज वाइफ वाज इंसिस्टिंग, जाने दो हमारा नुकसान होना है तो होने दो, हमारा 15 लाख गया तो जाने दो, 2 crore के ऊपर 15 लाख करो, अभी उधर से आया है तो वी आर रेडी टू पे. मतलब व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज इट इज अ बायस मार्केट, देयर इज अ बिग अमाउंट ऑफ अनसोल्ड इन्वेंटरी इन द मार्केट, एवरीबॉडी इज वरीड. बिल्डर लोगों का पैसा बहुत अटका हुआ है, एंड यहाँ पे खाली बिल्डर्स नहीं है, पॉलिटिकल लोग है बहुत है, आपको सबको मालूम है ये. तो इसके लिए आज आप अगर सोचोगे कि मेरा टोटल वर्थ कितना है, उसमें मैं कितना पोर्शन घर के लिए दे दू, एंड उसका मेरे को कोई फायदा है क्या, ये अगर आप सोचोगे देन इट इज वर्थ कंसिडरिंग रियल इस्टेट. रियल इस्टेट इज इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर एवरी वन एट एनी स्टेज ऑफ लाइफ एट एनी कॉस्ट व्हेन यू डोंट हैव होम. बट इफ यू हैव अ होम और हाउस देन यू डोंट नीड टू हरी इन दैट मैटर. हाँ आपको अगर 100% मालूम है कि प्राइसेस ऐसे थ्रो अवे प्राइस में मिल रहा है एंड आज उसके ऊपर आप पैसा बना सकते हो, देन इवन फंड मैनेजर्स एंड एवरी वन व्यू इज जब सेलर्स मार्केट बन जाता है तो थोड़ा सा ऊपर जाने के बाद भी आप ले लोगे तो भी चलेगा, then you are happy. Yes, Mr. Shetty. Who's asking me this question?
I'll go with the next question on the chat. So there are two contradictory statements of a financial advisor. One says close your home loan at the earliest, and the other says continue home loan as long as return on investment is low and its benefits. What is your opinion?
Okay. Now 50% of the reply was given by me when Mr. Satish or somebody else asked about that. Continue the loan. I'm not of the opinion of continuation of the loan when the interest of the loan is higher. When the interest of the loan is little higher than the prevailing rate what we get in deposit. Like suppose 7% we get on deposit and we are paying 7.5% or 8%. It is okay to continue with the loan. The reason is when we are paying loan at that time, you left out with some balance, because suppose you want to pay off the loan, then whatever is accumulated you have to pay off, so your cash surplus is going. Now suppose I am saying that there is a possibility that if you invest it properly you will 10% returns. So 10% is higher or 8% is higher? Second thing, that 8%, when you pay the loan interest, you get separate exemption on income tax up to 2 lakhs. So 2 lakhs straight away coming down from your taxable income, which is very good for you. So net, if you calculate the rate, it will not be even 5 to 6%. So it is better to continue with the loan and take the benefit of income tax also. So this is a view. There is no contradiction between any advisors. This one means I'm not criticizing anyone, because some people say that kisi ko मतलब कोई कोई लोग ऐसे होते हैं जिनको लोन ये वर्ड अच्छा नहीं लगता. तो नहीं यार, कुछ भी हो मेरे को लोन नहीं चाहिए, मेरे को शांति से सोना है. तो उनके लिए आप अगर 15% वाला भी स्कीम कुछ बता दो तो भी, देन इट इज फाइनेंशियल कंसल्टेंट जॉब टू अंडरस्टैंड सच पर्सन एंड ट्राई टू चेक व्हेन ही इज गोइंग टू बी कंफर्टेबल, बिकॉज हिज माइंडसेट हैज टू बी कंफर्टेबल. And to maintain him comfortable is also like I am interested in his prosperity. Because when he is comfortable at that time, he will be more focused on what he is doing. He will be earning little more. So all things keeping in perspective, one has to decide what is right and what is wrong.
Someone is asking you to suggest mutual funds, one or two mutual funds for 16 years period.
16 years is a long period, and we can always look at the risk appetite of the person who is investing, and we can make a very balanced portfolio wherein you will have all types of asset allocation in percentage basis. Like large cap will be say 10 to 20%. Or 30%, then focused will be another 30%. Focused and multi-cap will be say another 30%. Then mid-cap will be about 20%, and small-cap can be 20%. So that way, portfolio has to be, the ideal portfolio needs to be created. And that ideal portfolio, again, there is a question. Then what should we buy in small-cap? What should we buy in mid-cap? What should we buy in multi-cap? It keeps changing. आप अच्छे AMCs ऐसे select कर लो कि जहाँ पे there is a consistency in their performance, the consistency in their reputation, there is a consistency in the fund management. अगर समझो ये चीजें देख के आप select करोगे तो कभी कभी returns negative भी आया, so nothing to worry. Next year it will be compensated 100% because the fund houses has got that much call, because ultimately when they buy something against your contribution, they buy shares. So some shares can be in growth category or some shares can be in value category. Value category may not grow immediately, but when it will grow, it will grow better than growth category. So it will not be ideal for me to just tell you some schemes, but category selection is very important. And 16 year is a very decent time for mutual fund investments. So we can design the portfolio very nicely and explain.
The next question is, have some case studies of already retired employees for last 5 years.
Miss, in what perspective you want the case study? Because I got a lot of customers. I can talk about anybody, like, you know, little clarity on the question.
Sunil has asked this question. Sunil, can you unmute your mic and ask this question?
Larissa, we can go to the next question if Mr. Sunil probably can get back later on.
Yeah, okay. Nitin is raising his hand.
Okay.
Sir, unmute karke puchiye, sir. Nitin sir, unmute karke puchiye.
Nitin, you can unmute.
I'll try. Hello? Yeah. Can you hear me?
Yes.
I can.
Yeah. Question is, suppose I want to invest around 50 lakhs.
Sir, I can't hear.
Commercial property or in mutual fund?
Sir, there is too much noise.
It's not clear.
Hello?
Hello?
Yes. Hello? Can you hear me now?
Yeah, yes,
sir. I think you're logged in at two places, so there's an echo.
Yeah, hello? I got a surplus fund after this. Sir,
do jagah pe aapne login kiya hai. Isko unmute kariye.
After investing this, hello.
Hello.
After investing in these senior citizen schemes, I got surplus fund about 60 to 70 lakhs. Is it wise to invest in mutual fund or in commercial property?
About the property, I told you my view. But suppose that property is your dream and it is located in a very ideal place where ultimately you want to take it for long run or say next generation. And you can go in for real estate also, but as an investment option, unless that is a beautiful agricultural field or something, I am not very confident on real estate, sir.
Okay.
Yeah, in case you have that really surplus funds, you want regular returns, again, you can always go in Prime Minister's 10 years guaranteed 7.4%. Just in case these are idle funds. But again, I will come back and take a view of all your family members and all, and then suggest you what is the better option for you.
The next question is from Srinivas Kale. He says that he's down by almost 6 lakhs and still invested. Is it wise to continue or quit with booking loss and have income tax benefit?
Okay, if he's investing through SIPs.
No, mutual funds.
Yeah, mutual fund, but mode of investment is SIP, means systematically every month. Then suppose these are tax plans, then it should continue. But if the plans are other than tax plans, then we'll have to see the portfolio and give the opinion, because it may have large caps, it may have small caps, it may have such funds from where exit is recommended. So that overall we'll have to study and then advise.
The next one is about, they want to know about property investment.
Okay. I think on property investment I suggested, but unless somebody is saying me, I have about 50 lakhs with me and I'm getting one bank which is already running from that place and I'm going to get regular income from that bank in my name. Such properties are attractive. You understood what I said? There is a property like a shopping mall or something, and you know, two, three shops, and that is cost of that is say 50 lakhs and you have 50 lakhs to invest and it is already given on rent to some bank and bank is paying comfortable rent, then it is better to buy that type of property because it is already generating some returns. So it is from day one, you are going to get some returns. Such type of properties are available that too, not so expensive, then it is ideal. Because we will always say that your complete portfolio should have everything. But you have to check whether I am entering at wrong time or at attractive time. That one has to realize.
The next question is, instead of mutual fund, can I go for NPS tier 1 and 2? Because it seems it works as mutual fund managed by the same fund houses. Positive is the cost of managing the fund is low. Which yeah. NPS head should I go for as I am going to retire in 6 years?
Now here my view is totally independent. What he says that has got sense. Matlab, he's talking right. I'm not saying he's talking wrong. But as he has presumed, NPS tier 2 may not create similar funds like mutual funds, although it is managed by the same fund house because it doesn't spend anything on expenses. And wherever there is a spending and nothing is in return, then the fund management will not spend so much time on the managing same fund instead of managing his own fund where he is getting comfortable salary. Of course, this is my personal view. Means disclaimer, you can say. I'm not saying the NPS is wrong. NPS is good only for tax saving purpose. Whatever is allowed, claiming that rest of the amount you use in mutual funds. Because in mutual fund, even if there is expense, the returns are much higher than NPS. And you can verify that with the past performance and all that.
The next question is, can husband and wife invest separately in Prime Minister via Vandan Yojana?
Yes, yes. The limit is 15 lakhs for individual. Means in one family, 30 lakhs can go into that scheme. Provided they are 60 plus.
Okay.
And in this question, sorry. And in this question, I would like to add one more sentence. Those who will do this investment prior to 31st of March 21, that interest rate is guaranteed at 7.4. It will be guaranteed for all 10 years. But after March, the scheme is open for one more year. So one more or two more years, that scheme is open. So whoever is doing the investments in that fund, say after March 21, their interest is guaranteed or interest is not guaranteed and it will change based on RBI rate change. So if it comes down, you'll have to get less interest. If it goes up, you will get more. So it will be like that.
Okay, the next question is, how can we invest the retirement money to get regular income of specific amount monthly from that?
Yeah, there are a few of the options. Like we discussed now, for 10 years guaranteed is Prime Minister's Fund. Then there are senior citizen plans where interest is definite. Now rates are changing, but I believe today also whoever enters in senior citizen plan and while entering, suppose he gets 7.4, then that 7.4 is guaranteed for 5 years. So that is also a good scheme. Then third you can go in for any pension plan, immediate annuity plans issued by life insurance company, HDFC Life, Birla, Tata, many insurance companies. They give immediate insurance products. So you just verify whoever is giving you more and which is a quality institute, you go for that. So their interest rate, whatever is given to you, or the interest amount, that is guaranteed throughout the life. And there you also have options to take the interest lifelong with specific terminology. Means suppose you don't have to put anything for nominee, then your rate of interest will go up till 8.5% to 9%. But suppose you want to keep it for nominee, then your interest rate will come down to even 6%. So all these things are there. So based on that specific requirement, we can always communicate and we will let you know.
Those are all the questions. Anyone wants to ask any further questions?
Anybody has any other questions, or we can wind up our webinar for today?
And Rupali, my request is without inviting anyone for business or anything, I am open to everyone for any of their doubts or clarity purely on the basis of my relation with RCF. So you can always share my number or my email ID, and anybody can use that.
Surely. Thank you for that help, sir. So I think this webinar has been very informative, and sir has guided us in this present scenario, what are the corrective actions that we need to take, or what are the changes in our financial planning or thought process that we need to do. And having this webinar at this time, and Mr. Shah, you providing us with your inputs and your specialized inputs, we are very thankful on behalf of RCF and CMDC for helping us and providing us the right knowledge on this very important financial planning topic for employees who would be retiring soon or from the age of 50. What are the things that we need to take up? And once again, thank you to all the participants for participating in this webinar. And we look forward for such kind of participation in this kind of in this scenario in the future webinars too. Thank you so much. So we close the webinar for today. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, everyone.